Is there adequate blood supply for the ACL to heal on its own? The answer is yes. I'm going to draw it out for you right here. So I'm going to give you two views, one from kind of the front and the other from the back. That's the thigh bone, and it is shaped more or less like that. And then you have the shin bone that's shaped more or less like that. On the back side of it, so if you look at the front, you're going to have to kind of pretend that this is on the back. That's why I'm drawing in a dashed line. This is called the popliteal artery. It comes down the back of the leg. And the ACL is right there. That popliteal artery keeps going down, and then you can see it right there, and then it keeps going down. It becomes a tibial artery. But right here at the top, there is a branch called the middle genicular artery that comes down and gives a blood supply to that ACL. And then there's another artery that it's on the back side of the knee. It's called the inferior genicular artery. There's two branches, a medial and a lateral branch. It just means that there's one that wraps around the inside and one that wraps around the outside. And this branch wraps around this way and this way. And on the front side of the ACL, they come together and they supply the meniscus and other things, but it does give blood supply to the ACL. Let me just draw it from the side view here. So if we have the femur, more or less like that, and then you have the kneecap right here on the front, then you have the shin bone on the bottom. Your ACL is gonna be right here. That popliteal artery runs down the back, it keeps going down, becomes a tibial artery, and then you have that middle genicular artery that comes around. It comes into the joint, and it supplies the bone as well, supplies other things, but it does supply the ACL, the top part of it, with some blood supply, and then you have that branch that wraps around this way, the medial branch, then you have the lateral branch that goes on the other side of the joint, and it comes into the front and gives it some blood supply there. So the ACL does have blood supply. There is research to back this up. I've linked an article in the description below that has pictures and images. It's from a published research article. And there's other articles that show it as well. And there's so many cases of people that have healed their ACL and have proven that it has a blood supply. I mean, they've indirectly proven it by healing the ACL. And the benefit to having a blood supply is that it can get nutrients going into it that are helpful, like oxygen, sugar, all the things that are important for healing. Other components like vitamins and minerals that are necessary to rebuild the structure, the collagen fibers of the ACL. And then there's waste products that are developed while that ACL is healing, and those need to be taken out. So they're taken out through the blood supply there too. If you want to learn more about how to heal your ACL naturally without surgery, then you need to check out more videos here on our channel. I have a playlist called the ACL Tear Help Playlist that has all our ACL videos that give you tips, advice, knowledge like this, exercises on how to heal your ACL naturally. I have linked it in the description below. And I've also got a program called the ACL Tear Recovery Program that walks you through our step-by-step process, our unique approach on fixing the ACL and putting it in the position to heal so that you can naturally heal and avoid surgery. Go check out a link for the ACL Tear Recovery Program down in the description below as well. Thanks so much for watching, friends. I'll see you in the next video.